Hi, I'm David Cantor. Today I'm going to talk about slip and fall injuries. Now, every year, 8 million people are taken to the ER or have to get hospital treatment due to a slip and fall. And these statistics are from the National Floor Safety Institute. In fact, it happens so much, there's actually an institute on this. 2 million people a year, this happens because of improperly maintained floor surfaces. 1 million people sustain injuries that are considered to be substantial. Now, 17,000 people a year either have catastrophic or life-ending injuries. So this is a big deal. The most vulnerable are those who are 60 years of age or older. Negligent causes can be a wet floor. That's the most common that we see. Something spills in a grocery store and nobody bothers to clean it up even though they had notice. Disrepair of floors, bad lighting, clutter, cords that are lying around, and inadequate warning signs. You see that a lot when a sidewalk is under repair yet they don't put out a sign, or there's a manhole cover that's loose or ajar, or that there's construction that's ongoing and people get hurt. Now, what are the legal status for somebody can sue? Well, first of all, there's what's known as an invitee. What's an invitee? That's somebody who shows up in order to do business. When you go to a store, you're an invitee. You've been invited in to shop. There's licensees. That's non-business. What's a licensee? That's when you invite somebody to your house or you're invited over to somebody else's house. That's a social occasion. But if you're going up to go to somebody else's house and they don't bother to tell you, oh, by the way, there's a 2-foot hole in our front yard that we didn't bother to warn you about, you can potentially sue them or their insurance company. And then lastly, there's trespassers. Well, you're thinking, gosh, if somebody trespasses, it's their own fault. Not so quick. A lot of times, little kids are trespassers, but they're little kids, so there's what's known as an attractive nuisance. So if they see a tire hanging off a rope that looks really fun or a trampoline that's not secured, and they come running onto somebody's property, only to find out there's an uncovered ditch or hole and they fall and break their leg, you can actually sue the homeowner for what's known as attractive nuisance, even though the little kid was trespassing. It's because it's reasonably foreseeable that a kid's gonna go on that yard. Now, what are the damages? If you go to cantorcrane.com/damages or go to our website and click damages, you're gonna see the different type of damages that can be recovered. But in a nutshell, there's medical bills and future medical bills. There's lost wages or loss of employment, pain and suffering, and life care costs. This is a really bad injury. You might have to be taken care of for the rest of your life, and you're entitled to recover for that. Now, why use Cantor Crane? Well, first of all, we have the medical referrals that can help you out. The best doctors, physical therapists, occupational therapists, chiropractors, we can get you there quickly. They'll take your case with a lien, which means they won't charge you up front. They'll just get paid if and when your case settles at the end, assuming there's a favorable settlement. Now, in regard to jury trials, well, myself and Aaron have done over 200 jury trials of all different types. The other side knows that, and because they know that, we tend to settle cases quicker and for more money than most other lawyers out there. So if you or a loved one have been hurt in a slip and fall, give us a call, set an appointment, come on in and meet with us. It takes 30 minutes to meet with you, but it won't cost you a dime. But we'd love to sit down and talk with you. So I look forward to hearing from you soon. I look forward to seeing you soon. Take care.